Hello and welcome. I'm James Murphy, and today we're going to be installing Python for data science. Why is installing Python for data science any different than installing Python for any other reason? Well, when you're working with data, you often don't know exactly what you're looking for ahead of time. You just kind of want to play with the data and then decide what you want to do with it later. If you just installed Python directly, you're probably not going to have all of the tools that you need in order to interactively explore data. That's why I recommend that if you're going to do any kind of data analysis, you should install Anaconda, which packages all these common data analysis tools for you. Especially if you're new to Python, this can really help because you don't have to worry about what packages and things to install. Anaconda just comes with all the most popular ones pre-built in. You don't have to worry about anything. If you are watching this video, most likely you're looking for the individual edition. So let's download the individual edition. Most likely, you are running a 64-bit machine, and you should choose the 64-bit option. It's nearly half a gigabyte big, so it might take a while to download. All right, now that it's finished downloading, let's go ahead and run the installer. Click Next to continue and accept the license agreement. I recommend installing just for yourself, that way you won't need admin privileges. By default, it's going to install Anaconda into your home directory. Note that it's going to take up nearly 3 gigabytes of memory, so make sure you have the space before trying. Go ahead and click to go to the next step. I recommend not adding Anaconda to your path or registering it as your default Python. So leave both of those boxes unchecked. Then you can proceed with the installation. Okay, it finished. That took about 5 minutes for me. Remember, it had to unpack 3 gigabytes of data. Then go ahead and click through the rest. I wouldn't bother with either of these tutorials. You'll now find that you have something called Anaconda Navigator in your system. Let's go ahead and run it. This is a dashboard showing you all of the different programs that are either installed with Anaconda or available to download through Anaconda. The one that I recommend using for data science is Jupyter Lab. Don't get confused with the similar but older Jupyter Notebook setup. Jupyter Lab is similar to Jupyter Notebook, it's running the same code under the hood, and it's written by the same people. The difference is that Jupyter Lab is designed to be a more all-inclusive, integrated development environment, whereas Jupyter Notebooks are kind of just looking at single files one at a time. Let's go ahead and launch Jupyter Lab. Once Jupyter starts, you'll find yourself in your home directory. I recommend making a new folder for your Python projects. Go ahead and navigate inside the folder. Now we can finally create our first Python notebook by clicking on New Notebook. You can rename the notebook by right-clicking and selecting Rename Notebook. And now you can just type Python code into these cells. Once you've typed the Python code, you can execute it using Shift-Enter. Notice that a new cell appeared below the first one. I can write different code in this cell and run this cell independently of the other cell. The state of any variables you assign is preserved, so anything that you do in a previous cell can still affect other cells. But I can still go back and run previous cells again if I want to. I went ahead and downloaded a sample CSV file into this directory, which we can now load into memory so that we can explore like this. As you can see, I can see the dataset and decide what to do next based off of what I see. I don't need to have the whole thing planned out already. This is the main benefit of using Jupyter Lab. You can see the data and then decide what to do with it later. Go ahead and start playing around with it yourself. Now you just need to know how to effectively use Python for data science, but that's a different video. Thank you for watching.